What is up, guys? Good to see everyone again here on Dogumentary TV. It's been a couple years. First of all, I just want to say thanks for all the positive feedback we have received from our dog training fundamentals videos. And I am excited to say that we will be bringing some more videos back on regarding training, competition, basic obedience to advanced obedience. And I'm really looking forward to it. Some of the things that I have going on right now is, you know, when we first did our videos, Elevated Canine was just a two-man show. It was myself and my brother Christian, who you guys have also seen on Dogumentary TV. And now we have a team of 10 trainers, as well as we just got a new spot in Dallas, and we are looking to open another spot in Colorado. So some really exciting stuff happening for us at Elevated Canine. But you know what? It's time to get back to some more content and hopefully helping you guys with your dogs back at home. If you guys follow me on Instagram or, you know, Facebook, you guys have seen that I have a new competition dog named Rogan. He has his first leg of his French Ring 1. And then I also have a new project dog that I've been working, just came in 3 months ago, and he's a German Shepherd. His name is Recon, and I will be working him in the sport of IGP, AKA Schutzen. And I also have Alpha out here, who's a boxer, and she belongs to my friend Kathy Oaks, who you guys have also seen on Dogumentary TV. She has working boxers, and with her, we will be working towards hopefully getting her French Ring Brevet and her French Ring 1. All right, guys, so this is Rogan. He is Cushing. He's 2 years old. We competed maybe a couple months ago, got his brevet and his first leg of his French Ring 1. Today, I'm just gonna have some fun with him. One of the first things that I do is I let him know that we're about to start working, and I do this right before I go into competition by taking off his collar. So I put him up on my chest. Rogan. Yes. Boy. And I'm just gonna pay him. So I make sure I charge that. Yes. I charge that and let him know that we're about to start working. Done. Spin. Spin. Yes. Good boy. Done. Assis. Couché. Double. Assis. Couché. Double. Spin. Assis. Opie. Spin. Yes. Good boy. Done. You ready to work? Bien. Bien. Between. Good. Opie. Bien. Avec. Bien. Bien. Good boy. Bien. Opie. Do a little bit of retrieve. Asi. Rest. Asi. Rogan Opie. Sushi Port. Yes. Good boy. Good. He's a super cool dog, very fast, almost a little too fast. I gotta slow him down, but I really like him in the work. Done. Asi, you know, from Guapo, which was my first Malinois, to this one, I had to change some things around, make him a little more, not as crazy. So he should learn how to turn off, be amped up in drive, but then also learn how to chill out. Rogan, couché, double, back, couché, spin, back, spin, back, assis, bien, between, opie, you ready to work? You ready to work? Ready? Go. Good boy. Check this out. Get it. Good boy. Assis. Assis. Double. Bye. Good boy. Yeah, come on. Oh. Hey. Done. So, done. A lot of people, I get messages, how long should I be training my dog to get him to where Rogan is at or where Wapo is at? If I'm completely honest with you, I probably do one or two sessions a day, 5 to 10 minutes. And I do focus on specific tasks. I wanna make sure that whatever I'm working on, I try to get it down before I move on to something else. I don't do a session with a whole bunch of different behaviors. I try to get one thing down, or I'll do two different behaviors, but separate each one. Done. Assi. Double. Couché. Assi. Bien. Bien. Yes.
Good boy.
It's good? Yeah. All right, guys. So this is Alpha. She is a, she's not even two years old yet. She's a boxer, as you can see. She loves to work, but I'm gonna be honest with you guys. It's been tough. More because I'm so used to working with food, and she wasn't very food motivated. So, and I didn't wanna, you know, cut weight or anything like that. So I was like, we're just gonna use the ball. She loves the ball. She's crazy about the ball. So that's what I've been using for her training a little bit. And I had to figure out what she enjoys. Yes. She doesn't even grip it so hard, but she likes to just chase it around. She goes a little crazy for it. And what we're gonna be working towards is hopefully a French ring brevet, for sure a IGPBH, and then her ZTP, which is required for breeding in Germany. So her owners, Kathy's gonna take her back to Germany and get some tests done and whatnot before she ever decides to breed her. Done. Done. Assi. So I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of what we're working on. Right now we're working on some focus healing, and I am helping her by showing her the target, giving her a clear target. So I'm putting it over here. Oh, yeah. Yes. Good girl. Come on. Hey. Oh. Good girl. Done. Done. Assi. Come on. Assi. Opie. Assi. I'm giving her a clear target. I'm gonna back up. Yes. I pay her behind. She likes to forge a little bit, so I wanna make sure that I deliver the reward behind me. So when she wants to forge, she understands that, hey, the reward is back there. Why should I be forging? Reward placement is very important. Done. Done. Thank you. Opie. And I'm doing very small steps. See how she forges forward? Make sure I never pay her there. It's always gotta be. No. Good girl. Yes. Good girl. So anyways, that's a little bit of what we're working on. It doesn't look anywhere near finished, but that's the beautiful thing about training. You know, you guys will probably see her in another couple months and I could have a really nice focused heel, but I wanted to show you guys a little bit of the ugly and how it looks in the beginning. So this is Alpha, and hopefully you guys will be seeing more of her in the future. Lay down, down. Platz. 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 All right, guys, so this is Recon. He is a two-year-old German Shepherd, working line German Shepherd. I just got him in, gonna be doing some Schutzen with him, some IGP. Hopefully, you know, I could take him to the higher levels. He's a different dog compared to, you know, what I'm used to. When I first got him, he's, you know, we didn't have that relationship. And for people that have German Shepherds, they'll see that, you know, you gotta create this bond with the German Shepherd more than I feel than like with your regular like Malinois. Like Wapo, anybody could just grab him and do obedience with him. This dog required a little bit more bonding. Me learning how to interact with him, what he likes, what he doesn't like. There were certain things that would, you know, trigger him and he would growl at me. He's very, very possessive over the ball. So there was some conflict there. He would growl at me when I try to take the ball from him, which, you know, I'm not complaining. I feel that a high caliber dog that's gonna make it to the top levels sometimes need a little bit of this, you know, especially if you wanna get like that nice bark, aggressive bark in the blind for Schutzen. I think it's needed. Do all dogs need it? No, I think there's some dogs that work perfectly fine that don't have it. But with me, you know, this is a new type of dog that I'm working with, but I am really enjoying the challenge of working with him. Platz, done. Platz. So if you guys will see me work, I'm very careful, very calculated, and that's just making sure that, you know, I don't get bit. Platz. Here. Here. Good. Push! Yes. Good boy. Come on. So you guys will see that when I try to take the ball from him, he'll get a little weird. He doesn't, you know, he's a very independent dog. Come on, come on, come on, get your ball. Good boy. So I always pet him here. I never pet him from his face. Good boy. Watch. Platz. So you see, if you guys see this, the way he's acting right now with the ball right now, he's good now. But before, this will trigger some growling, some, you know, some snarling. And you guys might be, a lot of you guys might see this with some of your pet dogs. And you know, they're just being possessive over whatever they have. It could be their food, their toy, and it could create some big problems. So it's very important that you communicate with the dog the right way so that, you know, you guys have a clear understanding. I know where not to push this dog so that he reacts a certain, you know, so that he doesn't show me what I, you know, some that aggressive side of him. And then I have to be, make sure I, you know, that we have a clear understanding of, hey, this is allowed, this isn't allowed. Done. Let's. Platz. Platz. Done. Done. Puss. Puss. No. Puss. Good. No, push. Good. Good boy. I'm working a little bit on his rear end. He's kind of crowding out a little bit in the heeling. I want to make sure that it's nice and straight. Done. Sit. All right, guys. I look forward to putting out more content with Zeke. I know that you guys have really enjoyed the dog training fundamentals. We're gonna go back to some of that stuff because, you know, as everybody, we evolve and we change a couple things, and I'm looking forward to showing you guys some of the new things that I've been learning. All right, I'll see you guys on the next one.